Okay, E2, solve a system of equations by graphing. So again, we have this system of equations. And remember, system is two or more equations with or without unknowns. And so solve the system of equations by graphing. First graph the equations and then top the solution. So on this, we are going to graph. We're going to graph like you learned in Algebra 1. These are y equal mx plus b. So because of that, we need an m, which is the slope, which is rise over run, and the b is where it crosses the y-intercept, or where it crosses the y, which is the y-intercept. Okay. You are going to do the b, and then you're going to do the m. You do b before m because b comes in the alphabet first. So on this, negative 2 is the b. Negative 2 over 1, because remember we always need a fraction. We need the rise over run, is the slope. So we're going to do b first, which is negative 2. So we're going to go down 2 and make a dot. We're going to keep our point there and then look up and find the m. And the m is negative 2, which is negative 2 over 1. So that means we're going to rise negative 2, which means go down 2, and run positive 1. And whenever you do that, make sure the blue line goes with the first equation, because that's what it's looking for. And whenever you're drawing a blue line, it's automatically going to draw that line for you whenever you have your second dot. Okay. Let's go purple. So now we're going to do this one. Your m is 1, or 1 over 1, and your b is 7. Remember, do your b first and your m second. So forget about the blue line, and let's talk about the purple line. So that means that we're going to go up 7, and then we're going to rise 1, run 1. You need two points to make a line, so it'd be right there. Okay. So I should have been way better on the drawing this. Honestly, I forgot what I was doing. The computer's going to do this for you, so you're not going to have to stress on it. But whenever you get the two dots, and you can see right now that the blue and the purple do not cross right now, if we keep on going up 2, over 1, up 2, over 1, up 2, over 1, and then on our purple, down 1, over 1, and see where those blue and purple meet, then that is the solution. And a solution is going to be put in XY form. So where is the blue and the purple point at the same time? Negative 3, positive 4. So negative 3, positive 4 would be the solution after you graph these. Okay. Purple again. So this one's going to be purple. Our m for this equation is negative 1 over 1, and our b is 2. For the green one, the m is 1 over 1, and our b is negative 6. Okay, so let's do the purple one. So we did the b first, which means that we're going to go up 2. And then we are going to rise negative 1 and positive 1. See how this line is going down? That's because the slope is negative. The green line, we're going to start at negative 6 on the y-axis. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. From there, we're going to go positive 1 over negative 1. And see how I haven't crossed yet? So I'm going to keep on going. But again, the computer's going to do this for you. And the purple and the green meet right there. Where do they meet? They meet at positive 4, negative 2. Okay, so let's see. Now you're going to switch out. This is a new format, so bear with me. I want to get this one. And we are going to expand it over here. Yes, I do talk to myself. It tends to help me. Okay, so again, we have purple and green. This one is purple. So the M, whoopsie. The M is negative 1 over 1, and the B is negative 4. On the green, okay, the green is special. Why is the green special? Because there is no y in the equation. When there is no y, you are never going to cross the y. You are going to just cross the x axis. Let's go ahead and do that. What am I talking about? Which one's the x-axis? This one's the x-axis because there's an x right there. Where's negative 3 on the x-axis? Right here. And whenever I say I cross it, that means that's gross. So it means that right there would be the green graph. So let's go back to the purple. On the purple, we're going to go down 4. And from there, we're going to go down 1 over 1. But if I keep on going down 1 over 1, I'm getting further away from the green line. So let's go back to our original point and go up 1 and to the left 1. To the left is negative, isn't it? So up 1, negative 1, up, and there we go. Where did they cross? They crossed at negative 3, negative 1. Okay, we need a blue and a purple, so let's change this one to blue. Okay, so blue, M is 3 over 1 and B is 2. Purple this time, there is no X right here. If there's no X, then you're never going to cross the X axis. You're going to cross the y-axis at negative 1. Let's go ahead and do that. Here's the y-axis. Where's negative 1 on the y-axis? It is right here. If I'm going to cross the y-axis, then I have to go in the opposite direction of what it's doing. So there I'm crossing the y-axis. The purple is finished. Let's go back to the blue. We're going to go up 2. And then from there, we're going to rise 3 and run 1. But again, I'm getting further away from the purple line. So if I go back here and I go down 3 and to the left negative, I just did a negative over negative, which made it positive, which is a good thing. Right there. And where is this point? At negative 1, negative 1. Okay. One more piece of paper. And orange. Let's get some. Okay, let's get some orange. And blue. I'm going to do the blue first.
on the orange, we're going to have to do something first. We have x minus y equals 4. The only way that you can tell me what the m and the b are is if y is by itself. On this, the y is not by itself right now. The y is not by itself right now because, first off, there's an x on the same side of the equal sign with it, and there's a negative in front of it. So what we would do, we're going to take this negative, we're going to take the x over. If we take the x over, we're going to make it negative. So the y stays negative because it's in front of it. Now, in general, what y'all would probably want to do is bring the 4 down into the negative x. But since we know that we're graphing, we want the x to become first. So I'm going to put negative x plus 4 right there. I like my x to be before the constant. And then, see this negative sign? It can't be with the y before we do anything. So it's like a negative 1. We want to get rid of the negative 1. So we're going to divide everything by negative 1. The negative 1s are going to cancel out. A negative over a negative cancel out. Anything over 1 is just itself, so that's a positive x. And a positive 4 over negative 1 becomes a negative 4. Now we are ready to go because the y is by itself. Our slope is 1 over 1. And our b is negative 4. Okay, on the blue, y is already by itself. So all you have to do is look at it and say the slope is negative 1 over 2, and where it crosses the y-axis is at positive 2. So here we go. We're back to the orange. So we're going to go down 4, then rise 1, run 1, as many times as you want right there. Again, the computer is going to do it for you. And then the blue, positive 2. And then down 1, I didn't do that. Why did I do that? Okay. Down 1 over 2, down 1 over 2, down 1 over 2. I think the orange moved. The orange moved on me. Let me redo the orange real quick. Negative 4, up 1, there we go. See right there, that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking to see a blue and an orange together. And where's the blue and an orange together at? Positive 4, 0. Last one. Neither one of these are y by themselves, okay? You're not going to like it, but you're going to have to deal with it for just a little bit. So start with the top one. It doesn't matter which one you start with. And I don't know why it is so different. Yeah. There we go. So we're going to start with the top one. I am just rewriting it. Okay. So what you could do, lots of different things you can do. I'll just stick with one way. If you have any questions of could you have done it some other way, ask me and I'll probably tell you yes. So the 2y needs to go over to the left because most of you like the y to be on the left and the x and the b to be on the right. So I went ahead and moved the 2 over. I'm subtracting the 2y. So I'm bringing it down and bringing the 6 down. We are not putting the 2 and the 6 together because they're not like terms. Now we've got to move the 6 over, because it doesn't have a y. Now we're going to divide by negative 2. get y equals, which is what we wanted. There's a 1 there, if you needed to see it. Positive 6 and a negative 2 makes a negative 3.
Okay, so that is going to be our blue, which means m equals negative 1 over 2, and b equals negative 3. We go down negative 3, and from there we're going to go down 1 and over 2, go down 1 and over 2, or up 1 and over to the left 2. Orange, 2x plus y equals negative 6. This one's a little bit easier because the y is already 1y. So what we're going to do, we're going to move the 2x over. Positive y is the same thing as y. I like my x part to be before my b part, and since y is just y, we're good to go. Our m is negative 2 over 1, and our b is negative 6. Negative 6, negative 2 over 1, negative 2 over 1, I'm getting further away, so I'm going to go up 2 and over this way 1, and up to, there we go. The blue and the orange are together. Were they together? At negative 2, negative 2.